Hello guys, welcome to MasterG Tutorials. I am Apoorv and in this tutorial we are going to learn about multidimensional array. In the last video we have learned how to create a one dimensional array and store data in it. In this video multidimensional arrays are used. So multidimensional arrays are like table or matrices. They store data in rows and columns. So the memory allocation is different from one dimensional array. However, it is simple. So we are taking here an array A that is two dimensional array because it has got two indices, rows and columns. So A, so the first square bracket denotes rows and the second square bracket denotes columns. As I have written here 3 and 3, so it denotes that our maximum rows are only 3. So in the curly brackets I have given them the values, I have assigned the values to the elements. Now we are printing a message that is two dimensional array. So now we are printing the output. We are taking some elements to print. So guys, there is a mistake I have done here, but I have done it on sole purpose to make you understand something. Now let's run the program and see. So guys, as you can see the output is 40, and which is an element I never assigned. So the error is that I have written the column as 3. The point to remember is when you give and maximum index 3, so it starts from 0, 1 and 2. That is the maximum number of rows can be 3, but as the counting starts from 0, so we can go from 0, 1 and 2. And we have not assigned the value of A 2, 3 here. No value is assigned. So it gave us a garbage value which is 40. It can be anything. And in this case it is 40. So now I am changing the index and let's rerun the program. So we have 9 which is correct. Now we have another way of allocating values. So I am writing here curly braces. Now if I change the index, so it also ran correctly. So guys, 1, 2 means the second row and the third column. So you can see the second row is given by 4, 5 and 6 and the third column is, that is the third element is 6. So we have the output 6. Now let us see another thing about multidimensional array. We can also give the input from user. It's not important. Using the for loop. But here our array is multidimensional, so that's why we have to use nested for loops to store the data. One loop is for storing, for creating the data for a row, and the other loop will run for the column. So when I is equal to 1, that means our row, the data is storing in the row first, and the j index is used to store in the columns, that is in the row first. In the first row the data is stored. So I'll just copy and paste for output. So guys, let me run the program and enter the value 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 10. So guys, the array ran correctly. So if you have any doubt related to arrays, you can just write down in the comment section, and thank you.